This is a production of PBS 39.
In today's society, it's not uncommon to see people sitting in internet cafes or constantly checking their Blackberries. We can even hear our kids talking in computer lingo like LOL, laugh out loud. Similar technology is helping to save lives. Crystal Fisher took a ride with a Centronia ambulance crew to learn how.
We were the last ambulance available, and we were dispatched to a nursing home.
Seconds later, the dispatcher called back. Another ambulance could make it to the nursing home faster. These paramedics were needed at a nearby car accident. Arriving in less than 9 minutes, they immediately went to work.
6290 on location.
This man escaped a serious accident with only minor injuries.
Not every call is that life-saving call, but every call you're touching somebody's life, and probably the one time in their life they might be in an ambulance.
Paramedic John Wilderman gave his patient oxygen and kept close track of his vital signs on the way to the hospital. From start to finish, the process took less than an hour. And you can thank new technology for their speed and efficiency. Here at Centronia Ambulance Corps in Lehigh County, they recently underwent a $150,000 transformation, adding a new communication center and installing the latest technology to 19 of their advanced life support vehicles.
In Motion is one piece of a larger system that we're developing and deploying here at Centronia, in that this system is a mobile gateway.
The technology lets people back at the communication center keep a close eye on their crews.
Our one particular map will change every 5 minutes. Our other map is actually changing by the second.
Centronia dispatchers have been tracking where the most calls have come from on a daily basis since 2005. Here on the screen, purple represents the most calls. For example, on the biggest shopping day of the year, Black Friday, their historical data would show lots of purple on highways because of car accidents on the way to major malls. By using the new tracking devices and wireless connections on board, they can predict where calls will come from, which saves travel time.
It actually allows us to put ambulances where historical volume has been, and the accuracy of it is absolutely phenomenal.
We can position them in key strategic locations, which is why many times you'll see a Centronia ambulance sitting along a roadside.
Aside from positioning vehicles, the wireless connection has unlimited possibilities for the future, like transmitting EKGs real-time to a hospital, which will save time in treating a heart patient.
If somebody's having a heart attack, we transmit that 12-lead EKG to the hospital. The paramedics trained to interpret them. They take immediate action.
On the 19 updated vehicles, the paramedics have some things to get used to. The second paramedic on this ambulance is John Horner.
We've become more reliant on technology. When I first started out, it was a lot of the human factor. We had to do a lot of the things on our own. Technology's kind of come into every area of paramedicine.
Using the right technology, with the right training, with the right funding mechanisms, we can make a huge difference in how patients survive or don't survive.
Larry Wiersch recently celebrated his 25th year with Centronia. He's been around since the early days of emergency medical services, when ambulances were used solely for transportation.
The people that are surviving today, just because of what the ambulances are capable of doing versus when I first started in 1976, there's no doubt in my mind that we are making a huge difference.
Over time, ambulances have evolved. There's now a difference between what certain ones can do. An advanced life support vehicle always has at least one paramedic, like this John, who can read AKGs, insert air tubes in blocked airways, and give life-saving medication. Whereas on a basic life support vehicle, there are generally only EMTs, who can't do anything invasive.
There's a big level of difference in the training from the EMT level, which is 120 hours, to the paramedic level, which after you're ready in EMT is another 1,000 hours of training.
The paramedic on board is essentially the eyes and ears extension of the emergency room physician.
According to executives at InMotion, Centronia Ambulance Corps is the first in all of Pennsylvania to add wireless connections to their ambulances.
I think this is the future. I think that this community is very fortunate that we've invested such a tremendous amount of time and resources and capital investments to bring this to the Valley.
By pairing modern technology with skilled paramedics, the world of emergency medical care vehicles has entered a new frontier. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.